What's up, guys? Today we're going to be going over one of my favorite weapons in Destiny 2 right now, Martyr's Retribution, which is the new one-shot handheld grenade launcher from Season of Dawn. You can get this from the Mars Obelisk in Farming Sundial. And what makes this weapon so crazy is its intrinsic perk, Wave Frame. One-shot handheld grenade launcher, projectiles release a wave of energy when they contact the ground. So unlike other grenade launchers in the game, when you hit an enemy, it does not explode. It only explodes when it actually touches the ground. And when it hits the ground, it does this huge wave of energy, pretty much like a thermite grenade, almost like 20-30 feet long. And it does damage to any enemy that fire touches. So it pretty much does the damage of the grenade launcher over a huge area, as you see right here on the ogre. Then there's also two other ways of doing damage with this grenade launcher. The other way is by the explosion of the actual canister itself, then also impacting the enemy like that. And since this grenade launcher doesn't explode until it hits the ground, you can do some funny things where you can make it bounce and hit them multiple times and result in way more damage. For example, right here, I bounce it off the ceiling and it lands on them and bounces and hits them maybe like 8, 9, maybe even 10 times. Then it also does the damage when it hits the ground. So before we start really breaking down the damage on this weapon, I want to see what blast radius does to this weapon, because of the fact that it's pretty much the entire explosion is the entire damage. So as you see, the fire hits that and the explosion hits that with the lowest blast radius I can get on this weapon. Now if I increase it a bit, see what that does for the damage. And as you see, the fire does the exact same damage, so that is not tied to blast radius, but the explosion itself when you shoot underneath them is, and it goes up a little bit just like any other grenade launcher would. So now looking at the damage on Greg, the fire hits 15,026. The little explosion underneath him hits 6,541. And finally, the last thing you can do is the impact damage, which is 2887. And for this video, I'm just going to use the fire damage plus explosion damage for the damage numbers, because that is what you can do consistently on all enemies in the game, which is 21,567 damage. You can also increase that with the impact thing, but it's not very consistent. So for the purpose of this video, we're just going to use that number. And the cool thing about this grenade launcher is there's a lot of ways to increase the reload speed. You can use enhanced grenade launcher loader on your gauntlets, which takes it to 1.65 seconds. Then you can also just use one with field prep, which will give you increased reload speed while crouching, and that will pretty much take it to the cap, as you'll see right here, at 1.483 seconds, so it's very easy to get to max without needing something like Lunafaction or something like that. Now testing ready to fire 5 shots with this grenade launcher to see the DPS. That's going to take 6.183 seconds, meaning the DPS is 17,441, which isn't great, but not too bad compared to actually a lot of the other grenade launchers in the game. For example, Mountaintop on Greg hits for 23,853, which is only 10.6% more than Martyr's Retribution. Now testing the rate of fire of Mountaintop, shooting off 5 shots once again, just like we did before. Let's see how long that takes. It's going to take roughly 6.383 seconds, meaning DPS is 18,693, which is only 7% more than the Martyrs. So once again, GLs in general just aren't that great. But you compare both of these with Anarchy, which does 16,600 DPS itself, so that combo would be 34,000 with Martyrs, then also 35,000 with Mountaintop, which is a lot better than it was before. Not quite Izanagi's or a Sniper Anarchy combo, but not too bad. So the damage output of this grenade launcher actually isn't too far off that of Mountaintop, but that's not even what makes this thing 10% as good as it is. The Wave Frame intrinsic perk is what takes this thing to the next level. Not only are you doing pretty much Mountaintop damage, you're doing that damage over a huge area, which results in literally God tier Aghlir. Pretty much the only thing that competes with this scene in terms of legendaries is maybe Loaded Question, and that is exactly what it feels like. The fact that you're doing the grenade launcher damage over that huge range is so crazy, and it's so good. It literally feels like a ritual slash pinnacle weapon, and there's really not much more to say about it. Not only that, this weapon comes with amazing perks also. One of my favorite rules is field prep, which is increased ammo reserves, so more total ammo, then also a fast reload while crouching. Then the second perk I like using is Lead from Gold, where picking up heavy ammo also grants ammo to this weapon. And as you saw in yesterday's video, if you watched it, this perk gives bonus ammo. It does not take away from the ammo you get in your heavy, it just gives you more ammo for your special at the same time. So it's strictly just a positive perk and really helps with your ammo economy. With this build right here, plus a lot of grenade launcher perks on my armor, I pretty much never run out of ammo with this weapon. I can use it on bosses, Aghlir, everything, and it's really good. Another really good perk on this is Demolitionist, where kills with this weapon will generate grenade energy. Then also activating your grenade will reload the weapon from reserves. So as you see, since this is an energy weapon, you get a lot of grenade energy per kill. You get like 20, maybe 25% of your grenade energy every kill, which results in 4 or 5 kills to get your grenade. Then if you pair that with something like Devour, that takes it down to almost 3 kills per grenade. Then on top of that, you can also use something like Verity's Brow on Warlock, which will give you grenade energy recharge whenever you get an energy weapon kill. and that takes it down to a guaranteed grenade every 3 kills, and it also benefits your teammates nearby, so that build is very fun to use, and I've been using it off and on quite a bit. So overall, there's not really too much to say about this weapon. I don't think I've actually taken it off since I got it, like, the second day of Season of Dawn. It feels like a ritual slash pinnacle weapon, and if this was a new ritual weapon, I would have said it's probably the best ritual weapon they've ever made. The intrinsic perk Waveframe definitely feels like a pinnacle type perk, if not even exotic perk, and I just love this thing. It's so unique and so fresh. It feels really fun to use. It's very effective, really good ad clear, decent single target damage, pretty much right there with Mountaintop. And yeah, it's probably my favorite weapon in the game right now. Anyways, let me know what you think about this weapon. The rest of the video will just be a lot of gameplay, because the gameplay of this weapon really speaks more than actual words I can say about it. Anyways, thanks for watching. Catch you guys next time.